And I'm taking, I want to be a just like you, Daddy, as well, to get a bid on the casting and the mold of this piece so that I can set a price on it.
All right, this is going to be a video guided tour of the whole casting process, from delivering the clay to the foundry to how they cut it apart to the molds, all the way through to the end where they color the bronze. I've gone over all my videos that I've had on YouTube, collected everything from 2008 to 2014, and so I've got bits and pieces from each, one with a tour that I gave to a friend's wife who was dropping off her clay for their first bronze. And I hope you learn something from this video about the whole process of casting bronze. This is 6 years of videos.
I don't know. You know, I would double that thickness probably.
Okay, so if you got some clay that I could use?
Yeah, Matt's got some upstairs.
Okay. I'll take it up there if you want me to, and I'll just do it up there.
Yeah, why don't you take it up there? He can help you.
Okay. I'll just do that. All right, what I'm doing is I'm just going to thicken up the base a little bit here, because it's the stem going down from the clay itself is just a little too thin for the casting process, and they like to have a little more strength, so I'm going to double the thickness of the clay. So I'm going to turn off my camera because I don't have a tripod. And now I'm going to do the final act, which is signing the piece, and just show you what I'm doing here. I don't know if it's in focus, though.
Is that true? Something
else, okay? Yeah, see, this will work. Oh, no, this will work fine. Get my thumb, my finger out of the lens. I don't know what the edition size is going to be on this yet, because I've still got somebody that might purchase a copy, so if they do, it's going to be two copies instead of one, but it could work out to be just one of one. So, we'll see what happens. And I put the copyright, which is right there. That protects the image for my lifetime and then 50 years past it. That's the way that works. And I'll put the date down here. 5. What is today, 12? Yeah, it is, 12. 11. All right, that's it, complete. And I'm going to just leave it here, and then we'll find out what the costs are after they get a chance to look it over.
Pieces that will come apart, and then we'll also probably cut the legs here and here for casting.
Yeah.
And probably take his head something.
Well, the whole head will come off because it's just a...
Yeah, but we're going to leave it to mold it, though.
Okay, you're going to leave the hat on, too?
Yeah.
Because I got it, so you can take it off.
And I'll do a three-piece around the hat.
Okay. So you can see they cut the musket off already. So, Matt, how long do you think it'll take to make this mold?
A little over a week.
It'll take about that much time?
7 days.
Because you got to let each layer harden, right?
Right. And just all the preparation, getting it ready.
Yeah.
Is a couple days worth of work, and then it's going to be a couple days worth of rubber.
Mm-hmm.
And at least a day for plasters, and then the next day I'll be able to start taking it apart and getting the plasters ready. So.
Yeah, when they get the waxes, I want to come in and just check over them.
Oh, good.
So if you could leave a message for me.
Yeah. All right.
So anyway, you see how they prepare it. This is his left hand. And forearms, and they mount it on this thing. That's how they're going to make the mold of it. This is his back coat, and they're going to make a mold of this as well. And this is the musket and part of the coat lapel. And then he just gets all these things separated, and he makes these so that there's less work to do as far as pouring or waxing it, working on the wax. That cuts down on cost. we're going to go to the wax room now, where they take the rubber mold and that Matt makes and pour wax into it.
Hi.
Hi there.
How are you?
Good.
Now these are molds up here waiting to be poured into.
No, that's okay. Everything is up to par.
And they're not doing anything right now, but this is they have one pot of wax melted that's hotter than the other one. They do it cooler because the first one has to have a finer coverage, and then once they get that to do the first layer of the mold, then they put this cooler wax in there, and that thickens up the wax in the mold. And here's a mold that's had wax put into it, and that's how they get the hollow wax, is just by doing that like that. She's getting a thrill out of a warthog here.
That is
cool looking, though.
That is neat.
Be careful putting it back in.
Yeah, no kidding. I'll put it exactly like I had it.
Now, up here is another one of mine. Let's see. That's called Prayer on the Wind.
You really get the face.
You can turn it around so you can see it. And I got a little relief of his memories of life as he sits there with the buffalo who's disappeared.
Oh, God, I mean, you just get the face.
Yeah.
Oh, I like your base.
That is cool.
Got it? Do you have it?
All right, this is the wax of I Want to Be Like You, Daddy. And it's just out of the mold. It looks like it's not completely clean yet. There's a lot of rough areas up here on the top of the hat and some little nicks out of it here that probably didn't get completely poured out in the mold. This is what the young lady does that works on the waxes. She cleans those things up. Now, over here are the waxes of that little cowboy, ready to be dipped in ceramic solution, which they makes a second mold. You notice inside here, he's hollow. That's what they do. They make a wax copy, and it's a hollow wax copy. Use a paper cup that they've dipped in wax to be the pour spout, and these are tubes, or what do they call these? Brain's just tired. Sprues. These are sprues, and that guides the wax into the body of the young man once it's melted out of the ceramic mold. So that's that part, and you can see they cut off the back of his hat. That's so that they get an even pour. Now, this shows you how it's finished off here, hollow again. There's the top of his hat there, which is hollow, and sprues on these two items so that they can be poured. This all burns out of the ceramic mold, which is the next process they do. This here is the Plains Warrior in pieces. These are the arrows, the ends of the arrows that he's holding. How is he holding it? Yeah, like this. He's holding those like that, and that's cast separate. So that's the top of the arrows with the feathers, and then this is the bottom part of the bow. And that's just out of the mold. They haven't done anything with that yet. And here, what they do is they store these pieces in a box of popcorn. And as you can see, they're still cleaning this piece up. It's still got the seam from the pour. And then you can see where they've put a sprue here just to keep the sides from collapsing in. This is, somebody asked me what they do with the armature, and this is the armature rod that goes into the back, and they just cut this off and then clean off that part in this stage, and then they'll cut this a hole in there so that it's castable. And I'm going to go ahead and put that back down there. Now this is the bottom part of the Plains Warrior. Get this popcorn off so it's not spreading all over the place. Got some popcorn up inside of it. But you can see there's popcorn on under there, so I'll just get that out of there. You can see it's hollow. I'll run my finger through there. That goes up one leg. And there's the waistline where they join the two, the top half and the bottom half to it. This still has to be cleaned because there's still seam lines on it. So anyway, that gives you an idea what they do to prepare the casting. Let's take you over here. Some more of the little cowboy. Now I'm going to take you in the mold room, the ceramic room. This is where they dip the wax into ceramic solution, and you can see some of the molds. These are not my pieces here, these are somebody else's, but it gives you an idea what they look like once they've been dipped in the ceramic solution. And how many times do they dip them?
These ones have been dipped six times.
About six times?
Including the seal.
Okay, so they dip it about six times including the seal. And some of them, the bigger ones, they put chicken wire on just to give the ceramic mold a little more strength, because that bronze, when it goes in, is really heavy, and I've seen a mold break because of one little weakness in the mold. Now, he's going to do a process on one of these, so I'll just video that. This is not one of my pieces, it's somebody else's, but that's okay. It gives you an idea what's going on. Through the mold storage area, and these are all rubber molds by different artists, all stored on shelves, and this is just one storehouse. There's several storehouses. Every one of these shelves are just covered with different molds, and they're all labeled, and some are ready to go, and some are just being stored for the next time an order comes in. So, and that's a good 10 feet high, that shelf. So that just gives you an idea how much artwork they're producing here at Northwest Art Casting. This is where they cast the bronze.
Okay, so we come from where that sand is to
yeah.
Step.
Now they take the ceramic molds and they put them in this oven here.
Right.
That melts the wax out, and the wax pours down into that pan. They can reclaim the wax.
Wow, so now you have that
a vacant hole.
Shell.
Yeah, you're gonna take the molds that have been heated up to 1400 degrees. Well, that's a great way to do it, guys, instead of sticking your arms in there. Oh, this is wonderful.
This is too cool.
They do is they just take them over and put them in the racks.
Wow.
Let's stand right here. Are we okay here?
Yeah.
They're putting it in with asbestos on some of those bigger ones, and then they hang the smaller ones on the racks. Boy, you can feel that heat. Back over here. That's just over 2,000 degrees right there.
Let's skim it off.
How's it going? 2150.
Hi, Matt.
2150.
Holy mother.
2150, wow.
Yep.
2,150 degrees.
Well, I'm going to burn one of these now.
All right, now they start pouring.
I'll see my university yet.
Now this goes back thousands of years, what they're doing right here.
Yeah, kinda.
Not the same materials exactly, but the same way.
That's all we're
gonna
get.
Yeah. Look at how that puppy glows.
And look at that. And boy, let me tell you, that's hot.
No kidding.
You can feel it.
I can feel it 5 feet away. Didn't even think about it. I got my car keys, but I'm not
getting
those.
They put bronze ingots back into the crucible, and now they're going to melt that down.
How cool.
What'd you put in there?
Three ingots. Oh, cardboard.
No, in the bottom that burned.
That's cardboard.
Oh, cardboard, okay. Why do you put cardboard there?
Cardboard creates carbon when burned. So when it creates carbon, the crucible's made out of silica sand, so that stuff at really high temperatures.
It's like a little layer.
It'll start sticking, yeah, because it's silica sand layered on clay, I believe what it is, and that silica sand will slough off over time.
Yeah, I was going to ask you what the crucible is made out of.
Yeah, it's a silica sand on the outside and the inside.
So
of
it can
clay.
Stand many thousands of years.
Okay, that's the horse from this piece called the A New Beginning, and this is a mountain man coming out now. They're bringing him out here to cool off. They're spraying it with water just to cool it down a little bit faster. Why do you spray water? All right, the reason he's spraying water on it is because it takes out the hot spots. You don't want the bronze to cool unevenly, because then if it does, it cracks or it
bends. There's the bronze ring. It's there.
No, it's gold bullion.
Yeah, go pick one up and see how heavy that is.
Oh my gosh! Woohoo! That is heavy.
We go over to this place next door. So they take the bronze that they've broke out of the mold.
Yep.
And then they sandblast the bronze. Now see, this one's waiting to be sandblasted. They did repairs on it, and that's why you see a lighter color. That's where they've done the. Now they got to sandblast it again. Now, bronzes they can't color it or sandblast in that little unit there. They have to bring them in here to sandblast them. That's why, like that big bird. Yeah, but that's why that big bird's there.
That is a really cool bird. That looks like an egret.
Yeah. that's where they finish off the bronze. But let's take a look at where they do the welding. Wow. On a lobster, yeah. Working on a lobster right now. Can you imagine what the casting cost of that would do? With all those legs? Now this Lance, he does all my metal work. Final grinding and preparing it for coloring later on today. This is worth many horses, and you can see how she's cut up and not been welded back together yet. That's how the bronze is prepared for the coloring process and then the finishing process. Just working his little buns off.
Like a half a corn here.
Over this and just check on things. What's this little ridge right there? Is that just...
Well, look at you. I've got another one of flashes you can look at.
Yeah, because right that's I don't want that ridge. Yeah. And I don't want that either. Oh, thank you. What I'm doing is I'm just marking
little
things that need to be worked on. Can you stand him up for a second?
Yeah.
Now where I'm marking is things that he's going to work on once I leave here and go back to work on the other piece. I know that's me, but see how
I think they're just clay spots, but we can sure smooth them out.
Yeah. And just, you know, smooth out the finger a little bit.
Now I got some cross patch you need to do on it.
Yeah.
Feather to chase out. And we're ready for cross patch and sand.
Can you turn it just a little bit? Yeah, you got some things to do there, I'm sure.
Yep, a little sanding, a little cross patching.
Yeah, it really looks pretty good.
It's not too bad, but yeah, pretty decent. Getting pretty close. Isaac will put a final approval too.
Yeah.
But
I figured I'd just look over real quick before you get
might as well.
Point. Yeah.
Might as well.
All right, that's
a little hammer ding right there. You might
have
a little chipping hammer ding. Chip the
of course, off. I don't know. That's got a fingerprint in it.
Yeah, right next to yourself.
Could be me.
It is a fingerprint.
And if there's a fingerprint, that's me. So anyway, that's the color of bronze.
So what I'm going to do is I'm just a sandblasted copy of Worth Many Horses. I'm just going to go over it and make sure there's no outstanding problems with the bronze. Everything looks good. I think we're ready to go on this one. All right. We have a number on this thing yet?
Oh, no, that's the one thing I didn't know if you wanted to start with one or... That's not...
I wonder what Don wants to do. All right, so he's putting a chemical on here to darken the bronze. It's a cold chemical. He doesn't have to heat up the bronze in this stage. This is just the first stage of coloring a bronze.
Can I close it?
Yeah.
These are dark blue beads.
Okay. So these are all dark blue.
Yeah, and then on the yoke of the dress, do this kind of a red.
The yoke, sorry.
Yeah. Is that above this thing here and, and there. Polish that.
The beads are polished.
I thought we could go with this coloring on the beads. I don't think it'd be that hard to do. It might give it just a little bit more color too. It wouldn't blend in with that too much.
All right, what he's doing now is just with a just a kitchen Brillo, one of those plastic green Brillos. He's rubbing back the areas of that will be lighter color and not quite as dark. And we'll just keep on going with that. Okay, this is one of those Brillos. This is kind of an industrial one, isn't it?
Yeah.
But it's almost the same thing that you use for cleaning your dishes in your kitchen.
They used to use steel wool years ago.
We still do. But steel wool is really fine, and that's more of a finer layer. This has more grit to it.
Yeah.
You'd be surprised how many Blackfoot Indian women had brown hair just like that over there.
Yeah, it'll look black, you know.
Yeah, but
you just imagine sun splitting off it.
Yeah. Something I can't be in the room for is when they do the Inkerlac, which is a varnish that they put onto the bronze to seal the bronze and the colors, and to also lock down the acid so it stops its action of corrosion. So he puts on Increlac and then they put wax on top of that. So that's what they're doing right now, and I can't be in the room when they do that because it's very toxic. That's why he's wearing a heavy duty mask. Just put the bass on. I forgot to hit the record button.
Oh, great.
He put the bass on with the bolts. Now he's getting ready to put the swivel on with some felt on the bottom of the round board that goes below the swivel, and he'll attach that to the in routed out area on the bottom of the bass, and so the bronze will be able to turn and all that stuff. All right, from Northwest Art Casting and Bozeman, Montana, and Scott Billis here. He's the owner of the one of the owners of the. Bye.